السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق أجمعين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May the blessings and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his entire household. May he bless all his companions. May he bless every single one of us. May he grant us all goodness. Beloved brothers and sisters, as you notice, the days of Ramadan are coming to an end. And we are now in the 27th part of the Quran. You will notice shorter verses. These shorter, more complicated verses were revealed in Mecca, most of them. Because at that stage, the kuffar of Mecca did not want to listen to the Quran. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose a certain method in order for the Quran to get into their ears and to be digested by their hearts. رَغْمَ أُنُوفِهِمْ, which means even though they didn't want. So what had happened is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed very, very short verses. These people used to put their fingers into their ears. So whenever they heard the Quran, they began to put their fingers into their ears. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited short verses. وَالطُّورِ وَكِتَابٍ مَسْطُورٍ فِي رَقٍ مَنْشُورٍ. Each time they heard, they put their fingers into their ears, they had time to digest what was being said. When they released their fingers, the next part of the verse was in, or the next verse was in. Short verse. Very powerful, piercing. These are known as the verses revealed in Makkatul Mukarramah. They had their own speciality. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the sweetness of the Quran. We read this Quran and it is the most powerful book. This evening we heard the verses being repeated. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. Indeed, we have made this Quran very easy to understand. Is there anyone going to try and understand this Quran? The word dhikr also means over and above understanding. We've made it easy to be used as a warning. Is anyone going to take heed? And it also means we've made it easy to memorize. Is anyone going to try and do that? So this term is so powerful. If you read the surah that it is in, you will find that after the stories of each of the prophets, and Allah makes mention of the huge punishment that he sent down to these nations, immediately after that he says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. He says, look, we've made this Quran so simple to understand. Do you see what happened to those people? Don't repeat that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to understand. And this is why we say the biggest gift you can give yourself is to try and understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told you in his own book that he sent to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that gift. It is important as we continue, we make mention of one very, very important female who was praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala although she lived in the midst of tyranny. Who was this? The wife of Fir'aun. She was a woman who witnessed what happened. She knew Musa alayhi salam. She knew this young boy and she had brought him up in a certain manner to a great degree. And she knew that what he uttered was the truth and what her husband was saying was totally wrong and false. So she made a dua once to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah speaks about that dua in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ.
Allah has given to you the example of the wife of Fir'aun, who raised her hands and called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, O Allah, O my Rabb, O my Maker, build for me close to you a house in Jannah. Listen to the exact words. Build for me close to you a house in Jannah. and save me from Fir'aun and his oppression, and save me from those who are oppressive. This is a dua she's making. Now look, she said, build for me close to you a house. She did not say, build for me a house close to you in Jannah, because what is more important is the closeness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you're close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have everything. So even when we make our du'as, let us try and know what is more beneficial for us and how we should be making du'a. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. So this is made mention of, that such a woman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised her. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has praised her. She has been spoken about very highly. It is reported that she stayed over in Egypt when they were all drowned. She passed away later on, but she was a believing female. She believed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this in the Quran. And this is why sometimes, in the midst of tyranny, there is one person who sticks out and they might suffer great difficulty. It reminds me of people who accept Islam and their whole families are non-Muslim. Sometimes there are people who want to accept Islam, but what is stopping them is the comfort zone they are in. And this happens also with people who are wrong, but everyone around them is wrong. You find a Muslim, he has engaged in something wrong, he's oppressing a few people, but all his friends are oppressing the same people. So what will happen for him to now abstain or tell his friends, look, don't do this, he will stick out like a sore thumb. He'd rather be with them and continue. We need to understand, Islam teaches us, do not be like that. You make the difference, Allah will praise you with the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us through the lips of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he makes mention of the good worshippers of his on earth to the angels. Whenever you are remembering Allah, Allah remembers you. Fi mala'in khayrim minhu. In some other kind that are better than us. And this is made mention of, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers us when it comes to the angels, and he says, look at my worshipper. And there is discussion between them, as we made mention of the Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam a few days back. Now, they also has been brought to my notice by some of those who are sincere, alhamdulillah. Why is it that we say the Prophet Moses? Why don't we just cut out the English and say Musa alayhi salam? The reason is, I've come across a lot of non-Muslims who never knew that we believe in Jesus, may peace be upon him. They thought Isa is referring to something else. They think that Musa is referring to something else. They think that Harun is referring to someone else altogether. They don't know. So because our idea and aim is not only to uplift or to increase our knowledge, but to spread this even amongst the non-Muslims, it's important we also make mention of the names that are mentioned in the Bible, to say these are the prophets, here is the proper authentic version of what happened to them. You want to know it, come and read the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us. So it is not because we're trying to prove a wrong point, but it is because we want to use it as a means of da'wah and calling towards the right path. May Allah use us at all times to call towards the right path, and may He keep us on the straight and narrow, and may He grant us acceptance. This evening we have three beautiful stories that are mentioned in the Quran, incidents that occurred during the life of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. We will start with the first one, where there was a man, a very, very wealthy man. He passed away and he left one son, just one son. And this one son, he inherited everything. So the cousins were quite jealous and they murdered him. When they murdered him, there was a problem. There was a debate. Who murdered this man? Who murdered this man? So they went to Musa alayhi salam. They said, look, we need to know the murderer of this person. It's causing a big problem. It is splitting people, splitting communities. This is what is happening. It's causing a rift in the family and what have you. So Musa alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one day he comes back. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً. Musa alayhi salam came back to his people and he says, oh my people, Allah has solved your problem. He wants you to sacrifice a cow. You sacrifice a cow and then you will see Allah will release the name of whoever was the murderer. So these people, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, shaddadu fashaddadallahu alayhim. They didn't obey the instruction. They wanted to make life difficult, so Allah made it more difficult for them. This is why when we are given instruction, obey it. Don't just wait and ask more questions and so on. Obey the instruction. We'll see later on, inshallah. So it was very simple for them to obey the instruction and continue. But no, they told Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, there are many cows out there. So many cows out there. We are confused.
قالوا ادع لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي.
Make dua to Allah to inform us a little bit more detail. What type of a cow does he want?
قال إنه يقول إنها بقرة لا فارض ولا بك عوان بين ذلك فافعلوا ما تؤمرون.
He says it should neither be old nor young, something in between, an animal meaning a cow, neither too old nor is it too young, something in between, and do what you've been ordered, follow the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your issue will be made easy. Now they seen the cows, they had a category of cows, so the older were removed from their minds and the young were also removed, and they had this middle category of cows. They went back to Musa alayhi salam. Yeah, Musa, the middle category of cows are too many, so tell us, what's the color of this cow? Make dua to Allah.
قالوا دع لنا ربك يبين لنا ما لونها.
Oh Musa alayhi salam, make dua, call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let him tell us what's the color of the cow. So Musa alayhi salam made dua again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ صَفْرَاءُ فَاقِعٌ لَوْنُهَا تَسُرُّ النَّاظِرِينَ.
You want to know the color? It is a rich yellow color that attracts the attention of the people and is cool to the eye. It makes the people who look at it happy. So it's a rich yellow color. Something, let's say, more golden, a golden color of a cow. So mashallah, they started looking, they found quite a few. So they went to Musa alayhi salam, ya Musa, we've got a problem. We don't know which one exactly to slaughter. So now you tell us, make dua to Allah to tell us a little bit more detail.
قَالُوا دَعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ إِنَّ الْبَقَرَ تَشَابَهَ عَلَيْنَا وَإِنَّا إِن شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَمُهْتَدُونَ.
Oh Musa, we are confused. There's too many of these. And we don't know, they're all quite similar. So you tell us, ask Allah to give us a little bit more detail. And inshallah we will be guided. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds.
قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا ذَلُولٌ تُثِيرُ الْأَرْضَ وَلَا تَسْقِي الْحَرْثَ مُسَلَّمَةٌ لَا شِيَةَ فِيهَا.
What happened? Allah made it very difficult for them. Allah says, it must be a cow that was neither prepared to till the land nor prepared to be used for irrigation. It must be perfect without a spot on it. No mark, nothing. Now it became very hard. They started hunting for the cow. They told Musa alayhi salam,
الآن جئت بالحق.
Now you've come with something that is understandable. Now you've brought something understandable. So they went around, they started hunting for the cow. They found one cow belonging to someone. What had happened and whose cow was this? There was a man, it is reported, who passed away, and he left behind a widow and an orphan, one child and an orphan, meaning the orphan child and his widow. And he had made a dua prior to passing away. Ya Allah, I'm dying at this age. I'm leaving my wife and child. Ya Allah, I leave them in your care. You look after them. What did he have? He only had one calf, a little calf. So he instructed his wife before he passed away, take this calf and release.